Hi friends, welcome to Sri Chaitanya. Today I would like to share JEE Main and Advanced 2021 special, of which the total mathematics analysis of JEE Main 2020 papers and their topics and concepts, questions that are being covered under which concepts and which topics, this I am concentrating here, that too especially in algebra, because my friends, this information is very 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 valuable and useful for you and for those who are preparing a 2021 JEE Main as well as advanced. Because with this information, you will get the idea, okay, in algebra, what percentage of questions that are given in JEE Main 2020 under two shifts. One was conducted on January 7th, 8th, 9th, and the second one was conducted on September 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th. See, total 8 days. 16 tests, 16 slots, 3 subjects, 1200 questions. Okay, this is about what? JEE Main 2020 special. Of which now, today I am just concentrating in mathematics only, and of which the mathematics papers, 400 questions were given among 16 papers. And from these 16 papers, what are those 400 questions that are being given, that here we are focusing more here, and of which 16 slots, 16 papers in 8 days, of these 400 questions, what is the weightage of algebra, what is the weightage of calculus, what is the weightage of coordinate geometry, trigonometry, vectors, etc., etc. I am giving very very beautiful information for you, because with this information you will understand, okay, these are the topics in algebra and the concepts in that particular topics are very very important. You will get the complete idea about this. So my friends, see, this is about the percentages of number of questions that are being asked in JEE Main from all the topics. Actually I have divided the entire mathematics into 5 parts. One is algebra. From algebra, 45% of the questions they asked, and from calculus, next one is 30%. So from algebra and calculus, these two areas they play very good role and important role in JEE Main as well as in advanced also. Of course, now I am concentrating only on what? JEE Main. See the percentage number of questions. So 45% of the questions they asked from algebra, and 30% of the questions they asked from calculus, and the next important weightage topic is coordinate geometry, and from coordinate geometry they have asked 13% of questions, and from vectors and 3D 9%, and from trigonometry 3% of the questions they asked. Now coming to we are concentrating on algebra. So from algebra, from all those 16 slots and 16 tests of 400 questions, 180 questions were asked from algebra alone, and these 181 questions are coming under which topic, and how many concepts were repeated. Here I am giving the beautiful analysis. Now see my friends, so here I have divided the topics under algebra like this. Number one is matrices and determinants, linear equations. From this particular topic, 30 questions were asked. That is the percentage allotted for this one is 16.57. And coming to the second, permutations and combinations. And from this chapter, they asked 15 questions. From what? From 400 questions. The contribution of mathematics is 400, physics is 400, chemistry is 400. Altogether, there are 1200 questions. Okay. Now, from 400 questions, 30 questions they asked from matrices and determinants and linear equations, and 15 questions they asked in their permutations and combinations. Next, coming to probability. And from probability, 17 questions they asked. And fourth one is statistics, 15 questions they asked. Sets, relations and reasoning, this is fifth chapter. And from this, 25 questions they asked. And for quadratic equations and expressions, they asked 17 questions. And similarly, binomial theorem, they asked 17 questions. And complex numbers, again, they asked 16 questions. And in progressions, they asked 29 questions. See, my friends. So, the majority of the questions are coming under which topics especially? One is matrices and determinants. This is one important chapter. After that, sets and relations. This play very good role. And the last one is progressions. Actually, though they are as an independent topics, but as a mathematical tools, they are very, very useful. See the weightages, matrices, determinants, linear equations, 30 questions they asked out of 400, 30 questions they asked this topic, and 29 questions are from progressions, and 25 questions are from what? Sets, relations and reasoning topics. And of course, the next important weightage goes to what? That 17 number quadratics and probability, binomial theorem, and next, later the 15 questions are from permutations and combinations, 16 questions are from complex numbers. So these many number of questions they asked from algebra alone. Total altogether, how many questions? As I said, 181 questions exclusively from algebra out of 400. So the 181 questions are distributed like this. Now, my friends, coming to the percentage, the graphical view. And this is the graphical representation according to the pie diagrams. I have shown here. So this is about matrices and determinants, linear equations. This is about permutations and combinations. This is about probability. This is about statistics. And this is about sets, relations and functions, sets, relations, reasonings. And this is about quadratic equations. And this is about binomial theorem. And this is about complex numbers. And this is about progressions. So this is graphical representation, pie diagrams, statistics, I have shown it. Now coming to, under each and every topic, as I mentioned in the previous table, so from matrices and determinants of 30 questions, under what concepts they asked that 30 questions, this is very, very important. So if you have understood the concepts behind the matrices, determinants and linear equation, at least you can get an idea and you will strengthen more. And that knowledge helpful to gain very good knowledge in a 2021 JEE mains especially. Now coming to my friends, here now I am concentrating matrices, determinants and linear equations. How many questions they asked from this particular chapter? 30 questions they were asked. And of these 30 questions, see, this is the concept, types of matrices, algebra of matrices. So we know different varieties of matrices, different varieties of algebra means addition, multiplication, subtraction, and scalar multiplication of a matrix, etc., etc. And what is a trace, etc., etc. Mainly, product of the matrices are important because simply they are giving one 2x2 matrix. They are asking some important application regarding A power 4, A square. Suppose if A is a 2x2 matrix or B is some 2x2 matrix. They are asking problems and they have constructed the questions based on what? Integral power of that matrix. That means they are finding you to solve something about A square, A cube, A power 4, something like that. And the application related to this one. So from this particular concept, what is the concept? Types of matrices and algebra of matrices. What is the meaning of algebra of matrix? Algebra of matrix is addition, multiplication, subtraction and scalar multiplication, and what are types, what is symmetric and what is skew symmetric, and what is adjoint matrix, and what is inverse matrix, and what is Hermitian matrix, what is skew Hermitian matrix, and like that, triangular matrix, upper triangular matrix, lower triangular matrix, scalar matrix, like that several varieties of matrices are there. And from this particular area, the number of questions were repeated, what, 5. So out of 30, 5 questions were asked under this concept, under this particular concept. All questions are relatively easy. There is no ambiguities at all. Straight away several questions are linked with one. And of course, if you have thoroughly observed the questions, you make repetitions are also be there, because they have copied some of the questions from previous old JE advanced examination paper problems also. Straight away, the simple questions also they have asked under this one. Now coming to the second concept in matrices, determinants and linear equations. This is what? Properties of determinants and its applications, mainly adjoint of the matrix and integral power. See here, you know, different varieties of the properties of the matrix. Of that, how to write sum of two determinants and expansions, and if any two rows are equal, identical, and if any row contains sum of two elements, how can you express it as a sum of determinants of same size of something, and different factor concept, like that, so many properties are there. So basically, they have asked questions mainly on the elementary properties of determinants and their applications, and even that also they asked very good questions based on adjoint of determinant of adjoint of the matrix, and moreover determinant of exponent of some matrix, that means what is the determinant of a power n, where n is a positive integer. Okay, based on that kind of properties. And moreover, they asked very beautiful questions in what? In determinant expansions, where expansions, the terms of the determinant contains what? Linear functions in X. So, see, 5 questions they were asked under this particular concept only. See, what are the particular concept? Properties of determinants and applications, mainly adjoint of the matrix and integral power. So, if you are solving the problems, my suggestion would be, you please collect all important models based on these particular headings and you practice more on that, because problems were repeated. Only thing is numerical changes. Except other than that numerical changes, every problem they have been created and they have asked on the same knowledge and same oriented models only. See, the next one is expansions of determinant at which terms has linear functions of x. That means they asked determinant of x plus 1, 3, 4, something 2, x plus 5, something like that. Means whereas elements are what? Linear functions in x. Several times questions were repeated on that particular type of expansions of determinants. Of course, this is also the part and part of parcel of the above concept only, but anyhow, you need to solve some of the problems based on this, because sometimes after expansion you may get different linear equations or some quadratic equations and that, and based on that information they may ask the questions interlinked with what, nature of the roots of the quadratic, that kind of linked oriented problems also we can expect from this. So my suggestion is you need to practice this particular area. And coming to maximum minimum applications in the determinants, because they are asking, suppose if a 3x3 determinants, all the elements contains trigonometric terms like sine, sine square theta, or cos, tan, something like that. After expansion of determinant, you will get a trigonometric relation. Though based on that, what is the maximum value, what is the minimum value, or what is its local maxima, what is its local minima, some mathematical, that means maximum minima tinge oriented problems linked with determinant applications, they have asked, and in this particular concept, and 2 questions were asked on that particular concept, and these 2 particular models are almost several JE old models are there. See, if you have solved old JE advanced papers, you will get complete knowledge about, okay, this kind of questions only they may ask, especially from maximum minimum applications along with the determinants concepts. So, this knowledge will help you regarding this particular area. Now coming to the next one, this is very very important, solving and applications of system of homogeneous linear equations. You know the system of linear equations, of that is system of homogeneous linear equations is there, non-homogeneous linear equations is there. So when shall the system of homogeneous linear equations consistent and not consistent? If it is consistent, when it possesses unique solution, when it possesses infinitely many number of solutions, and what are the information or how to find the solutions. Similarly, and see the number of questions they asked exclusively from homogeneous system of linear equation, 6 questions they were asked. Similarly, for non-homogeneous system of linear equations, how many times questions were repeated? 8. So of 30 questions in matrices, determinants and linear equations, see the weightage exclusively from homogeneous system of linear. If you just, my suggestion is, you just practice all the varieties, very good models available in all textbooks, guides, materials, question papers, whatever things are there for you in your surroundings, better you need to concentrate more on these two particular areas and properties. These three are very very important, because see, getting 30 questions out of 181 is not a joke. See the weightage of the matrices, determinants and linear equations. So please, my suggestion, this is moreover easiest topic also. Of course, they are very easy problems, but sometimes it takes time to solve them. They are lengthy oriented problem only, because sometimes for to write all the solution, it takes time. So they are somewhat time-based questions also. Directly and straight away, they never asked what is the solution for, and which in options, if you are checking the answers only, that never possible. Only thing is how to find that solution, and with that solutions, they are asking, they are linked with the options with some other topics like quadratic equations, progressions, etc., etc. Some linked oriented questions also, but beautiful questions were constructed. Because this knowledge on solving a homogeneous system and a non-homogeneous system and basic information and properties of matrices will also be useful even for advanced examination also. So my suggestion is, again I am telling, if you are preparing the matrices, determinants of linear equations chapter, it play a very good role in all competitive examinations, even in 2021 JEE mains also. And only thing is, you please prepare your own notes and collect all the problems based under these headings and solve so many different varieties of questions, different kinds of questions. That will help you, and that will give maximum confidence level. They will improve your confidence levels, and you will score very good marks in competitive examinations, especially JEE main. Now my friends, coming to the next permutations and combinations. See, in permutations and combinations, 15 questions were asked. Of that 15 questions, now, as you know it very well, permutations and combinations based on, as far as my experience is concerned, they simply based on what? Two rules. One is, they are called, I think, counting principles, I can say. Of that, one is sum rule, another one is product rule. These two are the most important concepts. Every formula in permutations and combinations can be generated with the help of sum and product rule only. Rest all other things are what? We are preparing conveniently for solving other problems. But all other relations means what is NPR, what is NCR, what is NCR plus NCR minus 1, everything NCR is equal to NCS, what will happen? All that conditions, everything, they all the standard formula in permutations and combinations, one should get only with the help of, or one should prove only with the help of sum and product rule. Even the collection of arrangements of objects, arrangement selection of objects from repetitions, without repetitions, everything, and even the final results, one should get only with the help of sum and product rule only. So from that basic fundamental, they asked 6 questions, especially in this. Even in these 6 questions, old JEE models also be there. So my suggestion would be, if you are preparing all the problems based on this one, you please concentrate the old JEE examination paper questions also. JEE means both mains as well as advanced papers also. Okay, till 2019 or 20, you need to solve all old models under this particular heading. Okay, now coming to arrangements of letters of the word. So suppose different letters are given, assassination, examination. So the number of arrangements of that particular, number of four letter arrangements, number of three letter arrangement, total number of arrangements, like that. And that kind of letter arrangement problems, they asked two questions among 15. And coming to applications of gap method and string method. So when shall we use gap method? When shall we use the string method? And the applications of all these, while selection of the objectives or arrangements of the objectives or arrangements of the things in a row, in permutations as well as in the combinations, the applications of gap and string methods are very, very important. Again, two questions they asked under this particular concept among 15. Now next one is the geometrical applications. Of course, you know the number of triangles formed by the lines, number of squares formed by the lines, the number of squares in the chessboard. Some geometrical application you might have practiced with the permutations and combinations knowledge. But this time they asked very few questions. Only one question they asked, and that question is also very simple questions. But this is the important area, all number theory concepts. Number theory means factorial notation problems and step oriented problems. So number of zeros in this one, or number of terms in this one, or one expansion, that means factorial 2 plus factorial 3 plus factorial 4 plus factorial 5 and so on plus factorial 100, what is that sum, like that kind of number theory oriented problems. That means if the number is a prime number, then the application of a factorial with the prime number and a number of zeros and number of exponents, last digits, like that, number theory oriented problems are important. Somehow these are the only trickiest part in the permutations and combinations. So these are the important models in permutations and combinations, but first priority goes to the first concept, which is what? Applications of sum, product and standard formula of permutations and combinations. Now coming to the applications of integral solutions. Suppose some question is given for you. The number of ways of filling up of something question is given for you. So after that, you can convert the entire problem with the integral solutions of this kind. So x1 plus x, the number of integral solutions of this one. After that, the number of positive integral solutions, number of non-negative integral solutions. Applications based on this kind of number of integral solutions and non-integral solutions. Of course, they are a little bit different and high standard questions, but even then, that applications are very, very important, especially for advanced examinations. But this time, only one question they asked among 15 in permutations and combinations from number theory, number of integral solutions concept. The number of questions is what? One. So these are the concepts, important concepts in permutations and combinations. Again, my suggestion is you need to practice more on the first three concepts thoroughly. So where to apply some rule, when to apply the product rule, and in arrangements, if repetitions occurs, if repetitions not occurs, selection of how many things, even in that selection also, when repetition occurs, repetition of the things, selections, etc., thing, objects and things you have to practice. And another important point is number of functions from one set to another set, number of one functions, onto functions, bijections. Once upon a time, this is the crazy area of asking questions, especially in this particular heading. But again, among 15 questions, only one question they asked from number of one functions, onto functions, etc., etc. The question is also very trivial questions, and straight away majority of the questions are of the same model. Except two or three questions among 15, except two or three questions, all other questions are straight away they asked from your textbook only. So not necessary to concentrate everything, just you put your concentration more on the headings only, that's sufficient. Now coming to my friends, probability. So how many questions were asked from probability? 17 questions were asked. And even in probability also, just like in permutations and combinations, even in probability also, this is the most important area. What is the most important area? Addition and multiplication conditional probability. So what is conditional probability and when shall we apply the conditional probability? And what is additional theorem? And what is multiplication theorem? From multiplication theorem, how can we distinguish between event and independent event? And what kind of role the multiplication theorem will play in solving the problems? So that all applications based on addition and multiplication theorems are very, very important, as especially all problems regarding conditional probability. My friends, as far as my experience is concerned, conditional probability, of course, it plays very good role, because independent events are also part and parcel of conditional probability. Even Bayes theorem and total probability theorem also what? It's an extension of conditional probability only. But if you mastered the conditional probability, then solving the problems under this heading, there were nothing for you. See, of 17 questions, 6 questions were asked from what? The heading applications of additional, multiplication and conditional probability only. Now coming to independent variables and applications of independent variables, especially in tossing a coin, in rolling a die, or like that problems, we are applying what? Independent events. And straight away, sometimes the probability of A union B, A intersection B concepts, they are set theoretical oriented problems only. Sometimes they are asking questions under independent events. Even under this particular heading, old JE questions were asked, and 4 questions were asked among the 17 on independent variables. Independent variables, even it plays very good role in them, binomial distribution, random variable, random distributions also. So you need to practice. And applications of Bayes theorem, this time only 1 question they asked among 17. Of course, random variables and distributions. They are asking under random variables and distributions, what is expected value? What is expected value? And what is mean? What is variance? Actually, that mean, variance, expected value, you can get in the statistics also. But problems related with random variables and distributions are very, very important. See, then applications of Bayes theorem, 3 questions were asked, simple questions. They asked very simple questions. Even in random variables also, what is the probability of x greater than or equal to 1? What is the probability of x less than or equal to 5? That kind of maxima minima oriented limitations on random variable also they asked in JE mains examinations. Under that concept, how many questions were repeated? 3 questions. Similarly, binomial distribution. Actually, in binomial distribution, see, even in dice problems, in coin problems, especially we are using the binomial distributions. This time, they are also asked 2 questions from binomial distribution. And these 2 questions of that, these 2 are the previous JE models only. They are not the new models at all. Okay, next, all models on digits. You need to practice all models on digits. So even if a die is rolled, some of the faces on the dice, if 2 digits are selected from given digits, what is the sum is even, odd, and even in progressions applications also very, very important, especially in digits problems. So you need to practice all models on digits especially, but only 1 question they asked. Mainly you have to concentrate on what? The basics only. And of that, you give important on what? Independent events. Later, you concentrate on what? Distributions. And in distributions also, you focus on what? Random variables and random distributions and binomial distributions. Of course, this random variable and random distributions and binomial distributions, they are not useful for advanced examinations, but they are very, very useful for mains examinations. In olden days and long ago, several questions were repeated, especially in the binomial distribution also, then random distributions and random variables. Okay. Anyhow, the concepts behind the screens are very, very important. So of 181 questions, 17 questions were asked under what? Probability. Now, my friends, coming to the statistics, this is very easiest topic. 15 questions were repeated and 15 questions were asked. Of that, 12 questions they concentrated on what? Mean, variance and application problems. All varieties of mean, variance, they will give mean, sometimes they will give variance, and they are asking the relations between mean and variance, then the data related with progressions and progressions with arithmetic progressions, geometric progressions, even binomial coefficients, quadratic roots, roots of the quadratic equation, all varied. Wherever and whenever the applications of means and mean and variance are useful, they asked, they covered all areas. That's why, see, 12 questions among 15, they asked exclusively on what? Mean and variance. And from standard deviation, just 3 questions. Because if you know mean and variance, and finding the standard deviation is nothing. Because with standard deviation is linked with what? Mean and variance only. So thoroughly you practice all mean and variance. Just instead of solving problems straight away from the mean and variance, sometimes frequency distribution table also, through frequency distribution table, or sometimes from grouped data, from some ungrouped data, even from progression problems, even from quadratic equations and expressions chapter, even binomial theorem, you collect all those problems which are useful, the data. Because whenever you have a grouped data or ungrouped data, then there is a possibility of applying mean and variance. So you collect all that kind of problems. See, simply you can get the marks. All questions, 15 questions are straight questions. They are very easy questions. And only previous models, exclusively, majority questions are repeated also. Okay, straight away you can solve the problems. You will get the marks also, exclusively from this chapter. And it is a very easy chapter also. Now coming to my friends, sets, relations and reasonings. 25 questions they asked from this chapter. Sets, relations and reasoning. Of that, see, first, tautology and truth table. See, 9 questions, they give one statement. They will ask which of the following the statement is. They will give a contradiction or a tautology or not a tautology, something like that. So for that, what to do? You need to write truth table. So if you are familiar with writing the truth tables, then getting this or solving this kind of problems are very useful for you. So practice all truth tables, of which if last column contains all T's or F's, that becomes automatically what? Tautology, that you have known it, and you solve all problems regarding the tautology, statements related with that. And next one is, they are giving some statements and they are asking what is contrapositive and what is negation of the statement. See, of the 9 questions they asked under tautology and truth tables, and 6 questions among 25 they asked on what? Contrapositive and negation of the statement. And coming to applications of inclusion and exclusion principle. What is inclusion and exclusion principle? N of A union B equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A minus B. This is called inclusion and exclusion principle. So all problems related with this particular area. That means if they may ask some limited oriented problem, that means N of A union B less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, that means least value of N of A, greatest value of N of B, or N of A union B lies between, N of A intersection B lies between, like that kind of problems, that means cardinality problems, they asked under this particular model. Now the total number of questions are what? 2. Now cardinality and algebra of sets means what is cardinality means order of the set. So N of A union B, what, how many? N of A, what? N of A minus B, like that kind of questions also they asked. And under that 3 questions they asked, and of that old questions are also they play very good role. So my friends, these are the very easy topics, easy areas, and no twists also be there. If you are familiar with algebra of matrices, that's sufficient. Algebra of sets and propositions means what is A union B, what is A intersection B, what is A minus B, what is A delta B, what is N of A union B intersection C, all basic properties, that is commutative properties of union, associative properties of union, that kind of things. Okay, so all algebra sets and propositions, even P negation Q, what is negation of P implies Q, negation of P and Q union something, like that type of problems they ask, and questions are very easy. Next, three questions were asked under algebra of sets and propositions. Now coming to domain of inverse relations. They are asking, they give one relation, not function, a relation. Because every function is a relation, but every relation need not be a function. So they are asking relation and inverse of the relation. Okay, so one question they asked under that one. Next, equivalence condition. So they will give one statement and whether it satisfies 1-1 on 2 and symmetry, transitive properties. Okay, then only we can call it as what equivalence relation or equivalence statement, equivalence condition, but whether the condition is equivalence or not, that kind of checking property is also very, very important. And under that condition, one question they asked among 25. So this is about what? Sets, relations and reasoning. See, this is one of the most easiest area, and more number of questions were repeated exclusively from this area, and all questions are straight away they asked from our old papers and old questions only. It won't take much time also, hardly 1 week. Our worst case scenario, 7 hours is more than sufficient to get 100% of knowledge and good marks also on this particular topic. Okay, my friends, now coming to quadratic equations and theory of equations, 17 questions were asked. This is somewhat tricky area. Now, in that one, first concept is what? They asked questions on what? Algebra of roots of the quadratic equations. Means, they will give one quadratic equations. They are asking roots, what is if alpha and beta are roots, then what is alpha plus beta, what is alpha square plus beta square, and suppose if alpha beta are root of this equation and beta gamma delta are roots of another equation, then what is alpha by delta beta plus beta by gamma, some alpha square by delta square minus beta square by gamma square, something like that. So relations between the or algebra of the roots of the equation as well as algebra of roots of two equations also. In this one, and old JE questions also play very good role. It's a very easy topic also. They will give some relations also, they based on that roots. See, 11 questions were asked under this particular heading. What is the particular heading? Algebra of roots. What is algebra of roots? If alpha beta are roots of the equation, quadratic equation, then what is alpha plus beta, what is mod alpha minus beta, what is alpha square plus beta square, what is alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha, something like that, or alpha plus beta, alpha minus beta into beta minus gamma into gamma minus, like that, if two quadratic equations are given for you, like that, it's different varieties of models already been asked in previous examinations also, the same history was repeated again here 11 times out of 17, 11 questions scored or 11 questions were asked under this particular area only. Now coming to solutions and roots of the transcendental equation. See, the equation which is not algebraic, the equation which is not algebraic is called transcendental. Means algebraic means what? X square plus x plus 2x, like that. All x and y terms. Other than algebraic means exponential, logarithmic, trigonometry and exponential, modulus, step functions. Okay? Like that kind of mixed oriented problems. E to the power of x plus or mod of 3 power x minus 1 plus mod of 2 power x minus 1, something like that. An equation in terms of exponential functions only. An equation in terms of modulus only. Or roots of some step functions only. Like that kind of function, other than algebraic equations. And the roots and the behavior of that particular one. Even in that one also, the maximum minimum properties and maximum minimum applications. Like that questions, three questions were asked under that particular heading. Now coming to applications of maximum minimum with the quadratic equations. See, they will give one quadratic equations, they will ask straight away the maximum value, minimum value, local maximum, local minimum, and what is critical points, etc., etc. And one question they asked it, and roots versus roots of the quadratic equation versus progressions applications. Because suppose if alpha beta are roots and beta gamma are roots, and if alpha beta beta gamma delta are in arithmetic progressions, then the relations between are in geometric progression, then the relations between, like that progression concepts. So progression individually, progressions is a very good topic. As a tool also it is very, very useful. So several questions you can we can expect, or one can expect progressions with the quadratic equations, Okay, all the kind of models you need to practice. One question they asked this time, and critical points as roots of the quadratic equation. All that already I told, no? What is critical point? So when shall the derivative of the function becomes? So the calculus approach oriented problems are also very, very important. See, this is the beauty in quadratic equations. Calculus application oriented problems, even intermediate value theorem application also. To locate the root of a quadratic equation in an interval is also very, very important. Of that, critical points is very, very important. So critical points and roots of the quadratic equation, it plays very good role. Of course, though they asked that one question, but that creates maximum confusion in the minds of the students also. If you have done that question properly, you will score better marks. That's why don't neglect these areas. Though the area in quadratic equation, majority of the questions were asked on roots of the algebra of the roots of the quadratic equations, etc. But these maxima minima linked concepts and questions linked with the quadratics, with the calculus, with the progressions, with the binomial theorem, with the complex numbers, my suggestion is please don't neglect that area. So all concepts which are interrelated with the complex numbers, progressions, calculus are very, very, very important. Okay, so under these particular concepts, questions were repeated and they asked questions. Now coming to binomial theorem, 17 questions were asked under binomial theorem. Of that, of course, first one is your favorite area. What is the favorite area? Coefficient of some x power k, independent term, NGT means numerically greatest term. NGT means numerically greatest term. Numerically greatest term. Okay. And binomial expansion as well as multinomial expansion. Of course, though it is a multinomial, appears to be like multinomial, you can factorize it and you can separate them into two binomial expansions, also, product of two binomial expansions also. Like that. Easy level multinomial expansions only they ask. If you have very good knowledge on finding coefficient of x power k, independent term, etc. in the multinomial, you can straight away write direct answers also. Otherwise, you can factorize them and you can separately find the coefficients and independent term, numerically greatest term, etc. Anyhow, under this particular area or concept, 12 questions were repeated. And the next one is, again, as I said, what progressions is as an individual topic, it is important, and other than that, as an application also it is important. So all concepts of progressions which are interlinked with the binomial coefficients, they are very, very important. So that means, suppose NC1 and NC2 or NC something, some coefficients, they are in AP or in GP, then the relation or problems based on that, like that questions they asked. So one question this time they asked, and again maxima minima applications in the binomial expansions, and again in this particular area also only one question asked, and a number of integral terms. That means, suppose some 7 power 1 by 3 plus 5 power 2 by 3 whole power 6 or some like that, some binomial expansion they are asking, and even in this expansion what are the number of integral terms, like that questions. Of course, this was the old JE examination paper also, several times, even advanced examination also, in the straight objective questions several times questions were repeated on this one, and the same question was repeated even in JE mains 2020 also. Next one is greatest value and greatest coefficients. So in binomial expansion, what is the greatest value and what is the greatest term? Like that questions also they asked, and this is also very simple question and repeated also. And coming to the properties of binomial coefficients, you have several properties, properties with differentiation, properties with integrations and applications of integrations and applications of differentiation. While calculating and while solving several relations in between the coefficients, those all properties are important. Again, only one question they asked. But the major role play in what? First only, basics only. Rest of the things are what? It depends. So if under any particular concept, only single question asked means that question would be the what is called a trump card on that paper, in that paper. So sometimes if students may face difficulty in solving that kind of questions, or they get very good familiarity, with familiarity they can solve that problem very easily also. So you need to focus and collect all this kind of models thoroughly, then only you will score very good marks. My friends, again, in 2021 so far in JEE main, syllabus has not been announced. So among some topics in algebra, they may reduce, they may delete. Once after announced the exact dates and detailed syllabus, I will give the exact framework and neat schedule for you to strengthen your JEE 2021 preparation also. That I will give in next videos. Okay, please wait for that. This information, suppose if you are, of course, already you might have completed something. After, if you have completed any of the topics that I have covered so far, of that, whether you have completed the subheadings or concepts the mentioned earlier in this video or not, you just check it. That is the only suggestion that I am giving for you. Now, my friends, coming to the complex numbers, 16 questions were asked in complex numbers of one. First one is locus, region, and geometrical applications. Simple geometrical applications. Once upon a time, geometrical applications play very good role in complex numbers. Of course, even then, today also, it play very good role in for advanced examination. Whereas in mains examination, they asked very simple questions. They give what is the reason real part of z greater than or equal to 0. You are in a position to imagine what does it mean by real part of a complex number z greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 0. What is the magnitude greater than 0, magnitude of the complex number? So if you are that geometrical approach will give you maximum subject knowledge in solving some of the problems. Of that, you can get ideas of creating your own questions especially, and you can solve some of the models even in locus type of problems also. So next one is modulus argument and a plus ib. They will give some complex numbers, some a plus ib by c plus id, whole power something like that, problems they are asking. What to do? Ultimately we have to convert everything in the form of what? Capital A plus IB. Of that we have to find what is real part and what is imaginary part. So whenever a rational expression is given for you, what we do? We can convert, or it is necessary to find what is argument and what is modulus and what is A plus IB form. So based on that argument and modulus and that form, they are asking, they are converting, they are creating very good questions. And this area is very, very important because it is very severe, a very simple one also, very basic also. And under that concept, 8 questions were repeated. Now coming to modulus application with the quadratic equations and roots. Again, what I said, all the problems interrelated with the complex numbers was quadratic. And the applications, they are very, very important. So 2 questions were asked under this particular heading, and again applications of De Moivre's theorem. That means what is 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n, or cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n, like that you know how to write this one. And this one they asked only one question, and solutions of the complex equation. What is IZ play is equal to Z bar? What is IZ square is equal to Z cube? Like that simple complex equations are also they asked. And the question they asked in JEE examination was previous JEE main and advanced examination also. So my friends, these are the models in general they asked from complex numbers, of which first 2 are very, very important. First 2 are what? They are basics of the complex numbers. If you are thorough with the modulus and amplitude and the geometrical vision of complex numbers, then problems are nothing for you. Majority of the questions are being constructed in that particular area. That's all. Now, my friends, coming to the progressions, this is the most important topic in JEE mains, especially in algebra, because than a chapter as an application tool point of view also it is very, very important. 29 questions were asked under this particular topic. Of that, exclusively from GP, 11 questions were asked. That means nth term of GP, sum to n terms of GP, sum to infinite terms of GP, and problems, all problems interlinked with GP are very, very important. Similarly, AP, sum of the first terms, sum of two terms, sum of n terms, nth term, different properties of terms of AP, different properties of terms of GP, and relations between AP and GP. And the 13 questions were asked in AP exclusively. And applications of AM and GM individually, what is arithmetic mean and what is geometrical mean, the questions were asked. Again, arithmetic mean greater than or equal to geometric mean, AM greater than or equal to GM, this application. And three questions were asked under this particular area. And coming to the applications of sigma n square, sigma n cube. So of course sigma n square sigma n cube are also part and parcel of problems in AP and GP also. But once after getting the nth term in terms of n, so instead of applying again properties of AP or GP, it is straight away, if you are thorough with sigma n square, sigma n cube, directly you can get the answer. So applications of sigma n square, sigma n cube are very important, and two questions were asked under this particular model. So my friends, these are the most important areas in algebra that I have researched. All the thoroughly, all the 16 papers, and I have read all the 400 questions in mathematics, and I have collected this information for you to strengthen your preparation for 2021 JEE mains examination. Hope this will help you a lot. If you like this, you please share my channel M. Umashankar, and you please subscribe it. It is very, very important. Once after announcement has released, detailed syllabus has given, then I will give very good schedule for you also to strengthen for our JEE 2021. My friends, this kind of information that always we are been giving for our Sri Chaitanya students, and soon we are going to start one beautiful batch. Regarding this, if you have any doubts, you please contact your nearest Sri Chaitanya branch. Please don't forget to subscribe and share this one. Okay, my friends, and we will meet in the next video with detailed analysis of calculus for JEE mains 2020 analysis. Okay, thank you very much.